How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to be comparing two of the best web hosting services out there, Hostinger and Bluehost. So before I begin, if you guys are interested in any of these services and any of these web hosting services, I've managed to grab a few really good discounts that you may not find in other places, or if you just went to the website without a special link or anything, you may not really find it. However, I was able to secure a couple of discounts for both Hostinger and Bluehost. If you guys are interested, you'll find them in the description down below. So very quickly, what is Hostinger? Starting with Hostinger. Now, Hostinger has made its name by providing the cheapest web hosting services. Their plans are cheap, but very powerful. Hostinger is a fantastic web hosting provider for beginners and pros alike. Their mission is to make life easier for developers and their customers. To execute the mission, Hostinger offers you easy to use, fast, and reliable web hosting services. All their plans come with all the resources you need to run your website. Whether you're looking for a VPS or some shared hosting space, Hostinger has you covered with its wide spectrum of services. All the plans except the single shared hosting plan come with a free domain name. They also come with free website transfer, one free website transfer, that is. A specialist team will migrate your website free of cost. Free SSD drives come included on all shared web hosting plans. Servers are powered by Lightspeed, PHP 7, HTTP 2, and built-in caching technology. All the packages come with a free Let's Encrypt SSL certificate and Cloudflare CDN, and they offer, of course, a 30-day money-back guarantee. Now, that's a little introduction into Hostinger. About Bluehost, Bluehost is one of the biggest and most popular website hosting companies of all time. They offer you a wide array of hosting features at competitive rates that will leave you asking, how do they even do that? So let's say with shared hosting, let's see here, you've got the plans, the 12-month plans and the 36-month plans. Now you get a free domain name for 1 year in most of the plans, specifically talking about the shared web hosting plans. You also get this cPanel here called Blue Rock, I believe, which is their new and upgraded cPanel. Whereas with Hostinger, you get their own panel called the hPanel, which looks like this, obviously. I personally like this look better, but yeah, this is also very easy to read and easy to navigate, and it's just a great experience overall, no matter which one you're using. It's just, it depends on what you prefer at the end of the day. And of course, the servers with Bluehost are powered by PHP 7, HTTP 2, and NGINX caching. Bluehost offers free SSL certificates, of course, as well as Cloudflare CDN. Bluehost offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, just like Hostinger, and it is an official partner of WordPress. And Bluehost overall just provides hosting services with unlimited bandwidth, hosting space, and email accounts. It has a reputation of robust performance, excellent customer support, and competitive pricing. On the other hand, Hostinger offers cheap web hosting without compromising on must-have and important features such as performance, speed, and security. Now, Bluehost has a phone number, whereas Hostinger doesn't. They don't have phone support. Though Hostinger do have, they have email support, whereas Bluehost's email support is not exactly listed. So again, Bluehost has phone support, live support, chat support, and ticket support. Hostinger, on the other hand, has live support, chat support, and ticket support, just no phone support, unfortunately. The data server location for Bluehost is in Utah, whereas Hostinger is a little bit more varied here with the US, Asia, and European server locations. Now, the monthly price, the basic monthly price for Bluehost is $295, whereas it's $099 for Hostinger. Again, make sure to check the description down below. And we're talking about the very beginner plans here, no advanced plans or anything like that. So that's how it starts. And again, with both services, you get unlimited data transfer, you get unlimited data storage, you get unlimited emails. When it comes to hosting multiple domains, you do get that with Bluehost. However, with hosting, you get that, except with the starter plan, you won't be getting to host multiple domains. They both have their own kind of panels, the H panel here with Hostinger. This is how it looks like. And you get the C panel with Bluehost, both of which are super easy to use and very intuitive. You don't get any server uptime guarantee with Bluehost, but you do get that guarantee with Hostinger, and they have a 99.9 uptime guarantee. They both, again, have money-back guarantees, though, so no change there. As for dedicated hosting, it is available for Bluehost, but with Hostinger, you don't get dedicated hosting. You only get shared, cloud, and virtual private server hosting. The extras you get with Bluehost, you will be getting search engine submission tools, a $100 Google advertising credit, a $50 Facebook ad credit, and free Yellow Pages listing. With Hostinger, you'll be getting SSD servers and a 30-day money-back guarantee. That's about it for the bonuses, but you do get a lot of plugins. And, you know, when it comes to plugins, it just never stops with Hostinger. So yeah, you're gonna find out that there are lots of plugins once you visit the market, and yeah, it's usually a good time when plugins kind of make your life easier. That's what they're for, and that's exactly what they do with Hostinger. In fact, with Hostinger, you do get a lot of value, especially for the free plugins, compared to other web hosting services where you don't really get a lot. So, you know, overall, the good, I would say, with Bluehost, if we're talking about Bluehost, I would say the really good thing about Bluehost would be the variety of hosting plans. You know, you get Bluehost offers shared, VPS, dedicated, and cloud hosting, as well as options like managed WordPress hosting, giving you the flexibility to easily scale your website to your needs. You also get 24/7 support. In addition to some of the best self-help resources of any host, Bluehost has a veritable army of fast-acting experts ready to assist you 24/7 via support ticket, hotline, or live chat. They also have a great refund policy, because Bluehost will give you a full refund if you cancel within 30 days, and prorated refunds if you cancel beyond that period. Bluehost pricing starts at $295. Per month. Now, the bad with Bluehost is that you don't get any uptime guarantees, because Bluehost doesn't offer you compensation for any prolonged or unexpected downtime. Another pet peeve of some people could be that, unlike some of its competitors, Bluehost charges additional fees if you want to migrate pre-existing websites or cPanel accounts, whereas competitors might not really charge for migration fees if you pick the some of the plans. Whereas with Bluehost, it doesn't matter which one you pick. Even if you pay extra, if you get the extra, the big plans, the advanced plans and whatnot, you will still be getting charged for the migration fees. Now, the good thing about Hostinger is that it is super cheap web hosting, especially for those beginners that are just trying to start out a website without having to pay much, just something that really doesn't break the bank, and it's as little as a few bucks. You get a free domain name, free SSL certificate, free BitNinja security, unlimited SSD disk space. You get free daily and weekly site backups, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and it's only $0.99 per month, which is just amazing. And I'm talking about the single shared hosting plan, which is the cheapest plan. I would recommend going for the recommended plan, which will be, I believe, let's just go Hostinger plans. And the plans right here. Oh, this is HostGator, excuse me. So Hostinger pricing, web hosting. I would recommend the premium plan, specifically because you'll be able to get a great, and in terms of pricing, it starts at $139 a month, which is great. But if you're looking for further discounts, be sure to check the description below again. Unfortunately, there is no phone support, which is a bummer, and not every plan comes with their free site migration service. I believe you will have to go to with the premium, either premium or business, to get free migration. Free migration. If I think we can see it here. And not every plan comes with their free site migration service. I think Hostinger, obviously, overall, it offers quality web hosting that is aimed at both beginners and more pro webmasters. Web hosting plans come at super cheap prices without compromising on must-have features when hosting websites such as performance, speed, and security. So that'll be it for this video. Hopefully you guys got a bit of an idea of what these web host services are offering. Now, me personally, I think both services are great. It really just comes down to whether you like the bonuses that come with, or the pricing, of course. If you're up for paying for something, let's say like Bluehost, you can go with Bluehost, especially that they have better support. But if you like the bonuses and plugins that come with Hostinger, and obviously the very cheap pricing, and obviously the very budget-friendly pricing, then you'll definitely find Hostinger to be of value. So that'll be it for this video. Again, you'll find links to special deals and discounts for these web hosting services in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about them. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and learn more about general cybersecurity and learn more about web hosting. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.